This is in for repair, and unlike the other KCS, what was it, a 95 that I did recently, or was it a 98, this is been completely recapped and had, I guess, a lot of the tubes changed, and it still doesn't work right. The owner dropped it off today. It's actually wood. That's very nice. And this one, like the other one, is a super. It's interesting because this has a lot of the same knobs as the CTC9 that I'm currently filming at the same time. So we're going to power it up and get a baseline on it here. The owner actually replaced the electrolytic cans with cans. He didn't restuff them. He ordered them from Antique Electronic Supply, ones that were pretty close. And so let's take a look and see what we got.
Okay. Actually, let me get the NTSC generator. If I got it here. Okay. Boy, this has a really nice bright. Huh. The tuner definitely needs to be serviced, it looks like. Do you remember what the problems were he specified? He said it didn't fill the whole screen.
Mm-hmm.
What else did he say? The audio was not...
buzzing.
The audio was just a buzz, and he said the picture was really weak, right?
Okay.
Well. No one wants to watch me rotate knobs. Pause that for a moment. Roll. Vertical in the front? Okay, that's contrast. That's audio. That's vertical. Okay, there we go. Well, there's definitely problems with the tuner because this says I'm in between channel 11 and 12 and I'm on channel 4 with the generator. There, I'm in between channel 3 and 4. Of course the fine tuning is not going to do anything because it's not touching anything. Okay. So to start off, we need to service the tuner. The vertical linearity is quite whacked out. The yoke is tilted. The ion trap looks like it's off. Let's pull the back and have a look. Okay, well, now that we pull it down a little bit. Let's see. The tuner still needs to be serviced really bad, but it looks pretty stable right there. Let me move the yoke is disintegrating. Let's see if I can clercosnorphulate here. Yep.
Well, there it is.
Yeah, push the yoke all the way forward.
Okay. So. Yeah, looking a lot better now.
The problem is the yoke is disintegrating. The plastic back is shot. In fact, yeah, it's really bad. Okay, pause that for a moment. Okay, we're looking better. I need to put the circle on this, the other generator, put the circle on it so I can better line it up. Better align it. Let me see, where's the horizontal? Okay, here's the vertical. This is a very much like the other chassis that I worked on. Does that look about even size top to bottom, or does the bottom smaller, Chris?
Yeah, it's about even. But you've got, you know, an area at the bottom that's not deflecting to. Okay. I think you had it.
How's that look?
Well, it's now, seems like at the very bottom it's wider. You see that?
No, I can't. How's that? Decent?
Yeah, I mean, it's not perfect, but
I'd really like to see some more contrast out of this. But, you know, maybe fixing the tuner, cleaning the tuner will do that. Kind of doing this, going about this the wrong way. Pause that, I'll hook up to the box. Definitely has a point with the sound. And we have, I might try and adjust the linearity capacitor if I can get to it. Let me see. The horizontal drive capacitor. This chassis is laid out exactly like the one I just worked on, the 98. So all the controls are in the same place. Pause that. Well, I'm attempting to turn the drive trimmer. My real screwdriver got sucked into the abyss. You better shut it off. I can't work with it.
You're deflecting less now.
Yeah, I know. It's just about, basically what you want to do is back this.
Oh, there you go. Okay.
So that was just opening the drive up a little bit more. Definitely a very strong CRT. Let's see if there's an AGC control. Go ahead, pause it.
Rolling.
Okay, we have an AGC control on this one.
Oh, there it is.
Okay, that's too much AGC. That's overloaded.
Comenzando a caer meteoros ya, uno que cruzó por el norte de Rusia, que sembró y se, bueno, hubo cientos de personas muertas, otro que acaba de caer cerca de Estados Unidos, y estamos comenzando a ver lo que Jesucristo dijo, las señales en el cielo, cosa que no había pasado.
All the noise is the converter box. The low fidelity picture is the crappy converter box.
Al mismo tiempo, viviendo no cabe duda en tiempos peligrosos. Noé fue advertido de cosas que no se veían. Y dice la Biblia, con...
Alright, so we'll make this video part one, and so far it's just been adjust the yoke, adjust the AGC, adjust the vertical linearity, vertical hold, the centering, and the horizontal drive control, and let's see, there's one thing I wanted to point out. This is a common question that comes up. So this is channel... This is channel 2. Hold on, pause it for a second. Let me see which one. Okay, so some of the programming will be full screen, 4x3, which is what this programming is right here. And then a lot of it is going to be, I don't know, what is this, 16x9 or,
yep.
Or NTSC widescreen, 720x4. And you're going to have the gap at the top and bottom, and that's not the TV. That's the broadcast, the format of the broadcast image, and there's nothing really you can do with that. I guess you could probably stretch it, but it wouldn't look right. So in the next video, I will pull the tuner out and clean it, and see how the audio sounds when I have the ability to adjust the fine tuning, and then probably go through and align the audio demodulation, the ratio detector. So that's it for video one of the RCA KCS-122BAD. I got the tuner out, and it's actually a wafer tuner. For some reason, I was not expecting a wafer tuner. So, a lot of adjustments in here. Look at these brass screws, these capacitors. Pretty interesting. Looks like the owner did a pretty nice job recapping this. He even replaced the cap on the tuner here. And
replace that bulb. I wonder what that is. I wonder if that's an LED replacement for a 6-volt pilot bulb. So we'll hose it down good with this stuff and then rotate it around quite a few times and put it back together. So the switches, I'll put this in here in case the owner ever needs to service it again, because these tuners do need to be cleaned. And the switches are these, of course, these wafer things right here with the contacts on both sides. So what I do is just spray. You don't need much of this stuff because it's an like an oil type stuff. And it moves around quite, you know, and then just do that. And then you want to rotate it vigorously, which I can't do with one hand, but you really want to wrench and ratchet on this thing, you know, 50, 80 times around in circles. Well, cleaning the tuner and adjusting the AGC again made all the difference in the world. Now, some of the noise in there is the crappy converter box, switching mode supply and the crappy converter box.
Well, if we're going to stay up all night, might as well have some coffee. Good idea.
The vertical linearity is still a tad off, I can see it.
Human Atlas book. I don't leave home without her.
All right, he's certainly one of the most mocked and ridiculed politicians, and Jimmy Kimmel joined with Rob Ford last night. He stopped by the show.
How you doing?
I'm doing amazing. How are you?
I'm doing well. Why are you dressed like a magician?
Now, don't get me wrong. I am very, very happy that you're here. But why are you here? What good could come of this? Have you ever seen this show?
All right, things would get, you know, from fun to serious, as Kimmel suggested Ford actually get some professional help.
If you are an alcoholic, which, you know, listen, you know, if you're drinking enough that you can try crack in your 40s and you don't remember it, maybe that's something that you might want to think about, like talking to somebody.
I wasn't elected to be perfect, Jimmy. I was elected to clean up the mess that I inherited, and that's exactly what I've done. Maybe you've never...
No, I'm not playing. But I can see that your brother is a guy who really loves you. I can see that your family really loves you.
Absolutely.
It's nothing to be ashamed of. And I think it's a good example for other people who might be in a similar situation.
Of course, during his time in Los Angeles, Ford even dropped in on City Hall. He wanted to meet with Mayor Garcetti. The mayor was out of town. Ford did hang with Tom Labonge, the councilperson, and Mitch.
Cozy TV.
Circumstances as far as having kids and raising a family. He just happens to have cancer.
Several months later, and, you know, we didn't say anything. Nobody did anything. And I feel that...
the way the light hits it.
You can hear the buzzing there that I was talking about, that all of these seem to have.
No puede volver a levantarse. En cambio, un hombre fuerte lleva en el alma.
Hasta que en 1840.
¿Y qué crees que dijo la niña?
¿Qué dijo la niña?
Papá, mira, va, ahí va el Twitter.
¿Lo entendiste?
Sí, el Twitter del cartoon, ¿no?
Where's my music? Where's my music video station? Let's try a DVD. Do not ever buy an Apex converter box. Just the absolute worst
piece of consumer electronics I've ever seen. I have to tweak the audio a little bit because it peaks up on crystallization when there's a bunch of noise. That's blurry right there. So you hit the video peaking, clear up on the noise in the audio. So I'll have to see if I can't. Let's see. I operate the DVD player. Okay, too many remotes. This TV using a quad coil type detector and not a ratio detector. It's fairly easy. I know they give rather lengthy alignment instructions in here, but they got away from that in later years. All you pretty much want to do is peak the audio in this guy and then adjust this guy for best sound performance. Pretty much all we have to do is just tweak on this guy a little bit. And it's going to be different between each box you use. So the owner, I'm going to have the owner bring his box with him when he picks this up so I can make sure that the AGC is set for his box. And also the quad coil, but it's just A10. So of course A10 is just that one right there in between the audio output and the detector tube. Now I'll let the wind blow it closed. And something like this is absolutely perfect to align it on. So we want to adjust the just the fine tuning where we want it for peak crystallization.
Okay, it's book report time. We'll do them alphabetically. Today it's A through M.
I'm saved. I love being a Simpson.
Let's see, we have no A's. Let's go right to the B's. Bart?
Huh? Mrs. Krabappel, I didn't...
Attention, this is Principal Skinner, your principal, with a message from the principal's office. All students, please proceed immediately to an assembly in the Butthead Memorial Auditorium.
Damn it, I wish we hadn't let the students name that one.
Children, the times, they are becoming quite different. Test scores are at an all-time low, so I've come up with these.
I had an RCA Color that had really poor audio, and it turned out that the detector tube was one of those realistic Radio Shack realistic lifetime tubes, and the tube tested perfect. It tested strong, but it wouldn't work in here. The made in Korea junk. So I was wondering, that's an RCA tube. I might try switching that out.
You're failing English.
Me fail English? That's impossible.
Months, Nelson, you're failing history, geography, and math, but you're doing quite well in home ec.
Hey, keep it down, man.
Simpson.
Oh.
Lisa.
Great, they're all I have. What could I be failing? I'm smart and a teacher. Jim, that's the stupidest thing I ever heard.
Your father and I are very concerned about this warning. We really hope you try harder.
That's all of them. And I'm so proud you didn't try to forge my name. How about a present, son?
Well, I could use a new pair of hockey skates.
Done and done.
That's not fair. Why is Bart getting a...
They give two sets of alignment instructions here for the video IF. And one of them is just using the signal generator, and the other one is using a sweep with the markers. And I found the first way to be very accurate. I've actually, in the past, I've done this way, which is very easy because you're just peaking the transformers. And then I verified it with this other method, and it's come out perfect. So what I might do is I might just go ahead and do this. It shouldn't take more than an hour or two. The hardest part about it is going to be finding this mixer wafer contact under the access hole. I hope they show that here somewhere. That's why I like the factory service manual, but I don't have it on the 122. Okay, here's our negative 6 volt bias source to override the AGC, and then we have our VTVM here, and we have the signal generator, and I'm just going to sweep this manually with the signal generator, and I'm going to start turning it down. So that's 42.605, 46.5. I'm going to crank the power up a notch. See what happens if I just turn it off. Okay, let me re-zero it. 46.828. .003. There's nothing. Now I'm going to go back down. It's peaking at 43.77. And it's totally gone by 41, so the band pass is 41, let's say 41.6 to 46.95. Okay, we're going to start with A1 and we want 44.5, adjust for maximum gain, adjust signal generator output for 3 volts and meter when finished. Okay, 44.5, this right here, it goes A1, 2, 3. So we're going to start with A1 right here. And here we're going to go to 44.5. And we're already up above 3 volts. So we'll put that there. And now, this is fairly hard to do squatting on the floor, we will adjust this for a peak. And it was pretty much right on. And they want this for 3 volts. Set it for 3 volts. Now, A2 we want at 45.5. So we'll go to 45.5. Hey, that one was pretty close too. Okay, A3 is 43 megahertz. Okay. Isn't this boring? Isn't this the most boring thing you've ever seen? So we'll go to 43. It takes 5 minutes to align it. It takes, you know, an hour to set it all up. We're going to adjust this one now. Oh, well, that one was... That one was off, for sure. Okay, 47.25, adjust A4 and mixer plate coil top core for minimum. Okay, 47.25. Now, where is A4? And knowing Sam's, they probably got it all. A4 looks like it's that one right there. This one right here. Adjust for minimum deflection. Well, there is no deflection. I mean, there is no deflection. What are you talking about? So that one's right on. And mixer plate coil, I'm not even going to try and adjust it because driving all kinds of power into the set, I'm not getting any deflection. So it's... So one of them was off a little bit. All right, well, we'll disconnect it all and see how it performs.
The barefoot princess twirls and seems so amazing.
Look at how horrible the picture is off the converter box. All the noise in it. It's horrible.
Then you should go to the Four Seasons because it's truly a spectacle and gorgeous. You'll be very happy. Thank you so much for being here.
My pleasure.
Oh, thank you for bringing this gorgeousness in here. We'll be right back.
Enjoy.
Show.
In this game called life, things can change in an instant.
In this game called life, even love has its boundaries.
In this game called life, sometimes the one you're closest to is the one you can't trust.
You ain't ready for this.
Check your local listings for the season premiere.
Way to kill the moment.
Then, the show inspired by the true story of a blind lawyer.
And many other objets d'art, all of which brave men like my own father risked their life to rescue out of the mainland.
To asbestos, call the number on your screen now. Even if a loved one had mesothelioma or asbestos lung cancer and has passed, your family may still be entitled to a cash award. Mesothelioma is a rare...
This does a lot better buzz-wise with the text than the ratio detectors seem to. That's why I like the gated beam quadrature discriminator better. I think that's what they call that. Anyway, that's a wrap.